Hi, I'm Bill Griffith, an application engineer with Agilent Technologies, and today we're going to talk about the principles of heat transfer and measure a modern vacuum vessel. In the past, when we talked about heat transfer, we've used a Dewar vessel, which had a glass interior and the metal exterior. The modern vacuum vessel uses both a metal interior as well as an exterior, creating an obvious conductive heat path that can transfer heat. The claim for the modern vacuum vessel is it can keep warm liquids warm for 4 hours and can keep cold liquids cold for 8 hours. So to explain the principles of heat transfer, I have a cutaway of a window I'd like to take a look at. So I have a quarter cutaway of a window. This is a double paned window. And we're going to talk about the four principles of heat transfer. So the first one is leakage. This is an encasement window, so it's very tightly sealed, so there's very little direct leakage from the interior of the window to the exterior. The next mechanism is conduction. This uses a metal exterior, which is a good conductor, but the metal does not extend into the interior of the window, thus reducing conductive heat loss. The next mechanism is convection. Convection is when warm air goes against a cold window and then falls to the floor. To avoid convection heat loss, this double pane window has the gap. This air gap creates insulation, keeping the interior pane much warmer, thus reducing the amount of convection losses. In addition to that, this gap can be filled with a gas like argon, which is denser than air, creating even more insulation, keeping the interior window warmer, thus reducing our convection heat losses. The final mechanism is radiated heat loss. So this has an E-coating on it, which reflects both the ultraviolet light and the infrared heat away from the house, keeping the house cool in the summertime. And the interior pane is also coated with that same E-coating so that in the wintertime, the radiated heat is reflected back into the room. So with these principles, let's go ahead and take a look at our measurement setup of our vacuum vessel. Okay, here's our measurement setup. We have our 34972A. And our two vacuum vessels, one with a warm liquid, one with a cold liquid, and you can definitely feel the heat transfer near the lid of the vacuum vessel. I used our BenchLink data log software to make the measurements over a 24-hour period. So after 4 hours, the hot liquid had lost about 10 degrees, and after 8 hours, the cold liquid had only gained about 2 degrees. Over the 24-hour period, the hot liquid remained hot and the cold liquid remained cold. Using the 34972 and the free BenchLink data logger software made it very easy to make these measurements. Thanks for watching.